weird being in this position, this situation, trying to explain things and be spontaneous with you. And of course, this is a contrived situation, a contrived medium. But here we are, together at last.
Someone there to give me water every day. so close, they're inside my heart. Falling, 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 ripping me apart. Like water. Water every day. Water. The water I hear you say. Water. What a strange sound.
psychedelics, 50 years, to me, one of the big keys, the big points that could be made about this is that throughout human history, from the times of the cavemen in the caves and the beginning of the concept of the keepers of the magic knowledge, the secret knowledge, and the namers of the names, there's always been some form of basic hierarchical system, the chief, the priest, the chief, the shaman, the goddess, and so on. And there were the assigned and trained keepers of the secret knowledge. The secret knowledge normally being that received through revelation and illumination by seers. Now all those three words refer to light, illumination, revelation, visionary, seer. So what we're talking about is what people see and what is contained within light. It's not a verbal language, it's an image language. It's the language of light, of lasers, and now in this time, digital language. Don't know how to speak to you, it's very relaxing. So in those ancient days, people would find different ways to be intoxicated. And they would find different plants and different organic substances which would take them out of themselves into mystical realms, different paths of enlightenment, which of course is a word enlightenment means. Literally, in light is meant. To be in light is what is meant for us as humane beings. And the E on humane I put there for the word evolution. So we return to the concept of light and evolution many times. The possessors of and the controllers of illumination, the visionary experience, basically became the feudal lords, the owners of land, and by owning the land, owning in a sense the earth, or trying to claim the earth itself as their possession. Now we all know that's not possible, and we've all seen the results of this possession of the earth. It's just not scientifically possible to maintain the status quo in a state of flux.
Yeah.
Saying is that even with psychedelic drugs, you are limited by the internal programming, the imprints, the conditioning, call it what you will, the DNA and the environment. That means to me that psychoactive enhancers, psychedelic experiences are not in any way apolitical, because when you drop this chemical bomb into your neurology, your neurosystem, you are triggering, accessing and disassembling, you are cutting it up all your previous inherited perceptions of what we sadly call reality. That is a political act, make no mistake. And if you need evidence that it's political, think about the first wave of the psychedelic revolution or evolution, when communes, gay rights, all kinds of social and political and artistic and musical and graphic and commercial developments took place. This was no accident. This was actually inevitable. And it was these spin-off manifestations which were the real threat to the management company. If you'll go along with me for a minute and accept that this is a political as well as a personal evolutionary arena, I'll try and explain why I feel with my experience that it is so important to continue and to expand upon this path. When the people who own the land and the resources and the capital suddenly discovered that their lackeys in the ordered churches and their slave priests and priestesses of pseudo-illumination were being undermined, they legislated. Why? Because for the first time in humane history, millions of humane beings had had access to that mystical experience, to the visionary bank. This has never happened before. It has always been something kept for the elite. It was never democratized. No one knows the results. No one knows the implications, good or bad. But it's out of Pandora's box. It's out of the rites of Eleusis. It's out of the Catholic communion. It's out of the Mormon church marriage ceremony with the naked girls being anointed by the elders. It's out of all those safe, ordered, controlled spaces, and it's on the streets. Everyone suddenly has shamanic experience for a couple of dollars or £1.50. For better or worse, prepared or not, that's what's happening. It's like putting an electric shock through the community of unknown proportions with unknown results. The only known result is it's stealing power from the elite, from the feudal lords, and it's re-empowering, or in a sense, for the first time, truly self-empowering the people on the earth.
I seem to recall they said the word no when I was at home. In my house. Let's go.
Don't underestimate the power of play. Play around, play for time. Play with everything you get access to. Mess it up, break it, rebuild it. Tell everybody else you don't know what the hell you are doing.
There is just us.
everything's double talk now, everything's double speak, everything's lies and hypocrisy that comes from the top. And as the top mimics the mother and father concept, and the population is seen as the children of the top, it's not surprising that many people mimic their techniques and use violence and hypocrisy to survive. But it won't work. The trees won't listen, and the poets won't listen. And everyone at some point is a young, growing child who knows better than their parents, quite rightly. So the thing is just to speak to each other and embrace each other and communicate with honesty, to be daring, to refuse to collude in the lies and the killing anymore, whatever anyone may say. How was the British Empire destroyed? By a tiny little man called Gandhi, who in a sense did nothing, and by doing nothing, destabilized permanently a huge military empire. So one person can do a lot. One empowered, inspired individual can change everything for many others. And since this hyperdelic revolution, and I say hyperdelic to mean technology and computers and telephones and satellites, anthropology, to take the idea of psychedelic further and beyond psychoactive chemicals into a life attitude and a way of life. This hyperdelic evolution and community is now so large that it cannot be eradicated. It will always return. It's part of the oldest visionary lineage on this particular planet. It is far older than any of the executives in the management company are able to understand. Chop it all up, cut it all up, re-empower yourselves, repossess your own space. That's all there is to do. And believe me, it causes great mischief in those secret corridors of power.
Okay, weirdos. Sing to Jesus.
Begin, little end. What begins with those E-G's? Big A. I, big D, big L, little A, then big D.
Picture this. An 8-year-old boy dressed as a cowboy pulls a gun from his little toy holster, points it at you, and says, "Bang, bang, gotcha." Cute, huh?
Hey, Pa!
Guns.
Weldon.
Hey, Pa!
Guns.
that's attractive to our kids.
Those delicious, nutritious breakfast cereals shot from guns. Yes, shot from guns.
Can't stop. Get up in there.
We'll just sit back and wait.
Bursting forth the gigantic grains of goodness.
They want shooting, we'll give them their money's worth. Come on.
We'll just sit back and wait. Guess you can start on the harmonica now, Jingles.
Better put that fancy gun in your hand. You might need it.
All right. I'll take my gun.
Now we're gonna have that talk.
My money.
You see, in this world, there's two kinds of people, my friend. Those with loaded guns.
Gee.
Those who dig. You dig.
Well, the difference between justice and murder.
He's coming out. He's a horse.
Gosh, what excitement.
Go ahead. Hold up and shoot.
I was right there listening, and I just couldn't leave till I heard both the stories.
Time sure flies.
You only know how to play, or do you know how to shoot?
I'm gonna kill you with this one bullet if you try to take his gun. So, come on, take it. If you can.
Hand it over. You'll be dead before you can draw the hammer back.
That's so.
Good shooting. Very good shooting.
Where'd you get that?
Come on, boy. Stay back and hold two shots. Now, who wants the second one?
Well, you know music. And you can count. Bravo. All the way up to two.
Drop your gun, Bill.
Don't do it. He killed Sal, but we got four guns. He's only got one bullet left in that derringer.
One's better than none.
We got him.
Yeah, that's true. Count to three.
All the way up to six in my head. Maybe faster than you. One.
When I say three, draw. One.
If you say two, I'll kiss you.
Keep count.
Two.
Gee.
I'll kill the next man who speaks.
Gosh, what excitement.
Fight!
Hey,
wait a minute.
Good shooting.
Good shooting. Don't
shoot again, stop.
That wasn't Bill. That was me, Jingles. And don't break for that door again.
Stop him here.
Guns.
eyed fool.
What are we gonna do, Sheriff?
Start closing in. I'll come in from this side.
American Top 40, or see, we just said American Top 40 with a jingle. I can't say it again.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life. I had to start again. If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again, with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee.
Now I've been through that part of the country.
Across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea.
Now I've been through that part of the country.
Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA.
I've been through that part of the country.
There's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say.
I've been through that part of the country.
Thank you, Mike.
Not since the Beatles and the Rolling Stones has a group so captured the hearts and minds of young America. I'm Casey Kasem.
And that's what we need more than anything to get America back on the right track.
Well, I'll be doggone. I'll sure have to hand it to him. He flops on TV and then turns right around and gets his own radio show.
Today, I want to run the risk of ruining what is a lovely recession.
Boom, 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 boom.
Oh, say, can you see?
Ta-dum, 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 ta-dum.
At the dawn's early light. What so proudly we hail. Twilight's last gleaming.
Rocks.
The rockets, red glare. The bombs bursting in air.
And I mean, it is, and the stomping and the grunting. It is the most basic beat.
They flew through the night.
That our flag was still there.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner still wave?
O'er the land and on the free.
I don't even like to think about it. I think it's awful. And I think we must have done something wrong to get that way.
I ought to have my head examined.
That won't help us now.
I don't know what happened. My mind just went blank or something.
Now, we're up to our long-distance dedication.
Oh, boy. Good one.
And this one is about kids and pets and a situation that we can all understand, whether we have kids or pets or neither. It's from a man in Cincinnati, Ohio, and here's what he writes. Dear Casey, this may seem to be a strange dedication request, but I'm quite sincere, and it'll mean a lot if you play it. Recently, there was a death in our family. He was a little dog named Snuckles, but he was most certainly a part of... Let's go start again.
On your mark, get set.
Coming out of the record. Play the record, okay? Please.
I want the big boys to know that dog lives.
I can't get no satisfaction. I'm trying to make some girl. Sock it through me, baby. Let's spend the night together. Making love. Light my fire. Give me what you got. Said there was something that got them more than the words of the song. But they said there was something that got them more than the words of the songs.
We're counting down the 40 biggest hits in the 50 states. Here's the first top 40 hit for the Irish band from Dublin who call themselves U2. That's the letter U and the numeral 2. That's the letter U and the numeral 2. That's the letter U and the numeral... That's the letter 2 and the numeral U. Is that the way I say that? I don't know how to say it.
They said there was something that got them more than the words of the song. That was the beat.
That's the letter U and the numeral 2. The four-man band features Adam Clayton on bass, Larry Mullen on drums, Dave Evans, nicknamed The Edge, on... This is bullshit. Nobody cares. If we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand it.
Louder and faster, louder and faster.
Here we go, ready?
Louder and faster, louder and faster.
And first the guy's turn. Two and
we change something that we've been doing all along? Is it to just screw up things?
Louder and faster, louder and faster.
5, 6, and tear everything out.
The beat. The beat.
I hear the American Top 40 jingle. Okay, let's try it, okay?
The beat! The beat! That was the beat!
4, 5, 6. Turn, 5, 6. Basic step.
Okay, I want a goddamn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a fucking up-tempo record every time I do a goddamn death dedication.
4, 5, 6.
This is a last goddamn time. I want somebody to use his fucking brain to not come out with a goddamn record that is that's up tempo, and I gotta talk about a fucking dog dying.
1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6.
Louder and faster, louder and faster.
What is this fucking ponderous, man? Ponderous, fucking ponderous.
Crazy beat, dig that crazy beat, dig that crazy beat.
I don't like it.
Why?
Because they're gonna be too powerful again like they did the last time.
Hey, Hang, have you ever stopped to think of this? You might be a dunk. Do you know what a dunk is? Well, if you don't, I'll tell you.
You make your family's life much brighter. You will find your work much lighter. It's as easy as can be to live better electrically. You can have more time for fun and pleasure. Family moments you will treasure. It's an opportunity to live better electrically.
Modern folks have learned to save their time and energy too.
You don't have to work and slave. Let electricity do it for you. You can have your cake and you can eat it. Make life sweet, it's hard to beat it. What a thrill to be so free when you live electrically.
One nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I used to be a drunk. A chronic drunk driver. In 10 years between my first arrest and having my license revoked, I racked up 19 major traffic violations. I caused 6 serious accidents. Injured 3 people beside myself. And had my license suspended twice.
Got a thirst, love, for a manlier brew. This time, make it ale. Valentine ale. My kind of guy drinks it. Maybe you're my kind of guy. Valentine ale has a taste you can feel.
This is American Top 40, right here on the radio station you grew up with. Music Radio 138. Oh, fuck.
There's a man
friends.
Climbed the highest mountains, and guess what? I've run through the fields only to be with you. Yep, with you, no one else, just you. And guess what? I have run, I have crawled, I have scaled these city walls. Yeah, that's really great. I can't believe I did it. But nevertheless, I have done that for you, only to be with you. I have done all these things, yeah, with you. The fat one, that's it. You're the fat one, and I want to be with you. Come on, I want to be with you. I don't believe it. I want to be with you. But on the other hand, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But on the other hand, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Nope, definitely not. I haven't found it. Nope, definitely not. I haven't found it. Here's what else I've done. I have kissed honey lips, felt the healing in her fingertips. I've even done that! While I was doing that, you know all the kissing on the honey lips? It burned like fire, and it reminded me of cheap melted plastic, the kind that makes little clouds of white vapor gas. Ooh, I like that vapor gas. It's kind of heavier than air, and it kind of slinks along the baseboard. And then when it bursts into flame, it makes those little strings of black smoke with little black ashes attached to them. Isn't that nice? That's how I was kissing honey lips. After all that, I still haven't found it. What I'm looking for, that is. I just don't know what to do. I just can't seem to find it. In the night, and cold as a stone I was, and I believe in kingdom come, and all the colors bleeding into one big mess. Boy, that reminds me of Big Butt when he does a big circular mess on the carpet upstairs. I have to whip out the Bissell deep cleaning steam machine, then get the tea kettle and heat some water. Dump the hot water on the circular mess and then take care of it with the Bissell. Maybe I'll have to get out the STP cleaner on that one also. Maybe the 409, but I'm not sure yet. Here's what else. You broke the bonds. You broke the goddamn bonds. You loosened the chains. You carried across and my shame. And my shame. Shame, 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 shame. So much shame. You know, I believe it. Oh, no. I guess I don't believe it. I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know what I'm talking about. But nevertheless, I still haven't found it. I haven't found what I'm looking for. I haven't found it. I'm looking for it, but I don't even know where it is. I don't even know anything anymore. I don't really know what to do. Or do I? But I still haven't found it. No, that doesn't make any sense either, does it? I just don't know much of anything anymore. Maybe I ought to be shot point blank in the stamper right here tonight. Wouldn't that be just nice? Yeah.
That damn Silverman office back again.
Well, I'll be jiggered. Look up there. Up there? I don't believe it. I'll be jiggered.
Like
there it is. I think I found it. There it is. Hey, no, it's moving around. There it is back. Way in the back now. There it is. Yes, I think I'm happy now. I found it. I really found it. And boy, am I so happy. And just so dumb.
The world is so full of a number of things, I'm sure we should all be as happy as kings.
At this moment, I'm the happiest young girl in the world.
Leave.
Servants of the soul.
What?
Or my thumb.
Yeah.
Mr. Nobody. Mr. Nobody.
You're overreacting.
Mr. Nobody.
Monsieur, two dogs, two pies. We knew that Monsieur would be hungry.
My son Andy Kev. By the way, my name's Graham Kev.
You never see how in Titus Andronicus the Queen tomorrow was served her own children baked in a pie. Of course, in your case,
we was just only him. He made his first attempt to follow in my footsteps. I think he was jolly successful. You know what he cooked? His favorite dish, scrambled eggs. They were soft and creamy, and I really couldn't have done better myself.
I'd like a piece of...
I'd like to share our secret for perfect scrambled eggs. just whip 4 eggs together without liquid. And season them. And then pop them into melted butter. You know, when the butter is just at the point of browning and smells like hazelnuts.
This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
That's the time to add the eggs. Stir them rapidly. Stir them rapidly. Stir them rapidly. And when they look just right, add 1/4 cup of cold milk. And stir again until they heat it through. This little trick halts the cooking process that so often makes eggs dry. Fresh eggs are one of the world's great delicacies. They deserve to be treated with respect.
I'd like a piece of... Loaf of bread!
You know, we better train some more scientists and engineers real soon, or we'll be in trouble.
The slightest error can alter, disable, or destroy one's image.
Into history a little bit.
And about power.
WA6OTB with a question.
You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
And about power.
You meant?
We got so much power now.
You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
We got so much power now. That's ridiculous.
You meant? You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
Power. That's power. We got so much power. That's ridiculous.
We have
power, 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 power now. Ridiculous. We got so much power now.
You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
It's not even funny.
You meant?
That's ridiculous.
You know how many?
It's not even funny.
You meant?
That's ridiculous.
You know how many?
That's ridiculous.
You know how many times?
That's ridiculous. It's not even funny.
You meant?
It's not even funny. It's not even funny.
You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
It's not even funny. How many time zones?
Yeah. We have four in this country, right?
How many time zones?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Four in this country, right?
Yes, sir. 4. 1, 2, 3. Yes, sir.
Right?
1, 2, 3. Yes, sir. 4 time zones?
Yeah. We have four in this country, right?
No, sir.
We have.
Yes, sir.
Do you know how many time zones they have?
Yes, sir. 4. No, sir. I never really studied that up.
11.
11. It's not even funny.
11.
11. That's ridiculous.
11.
11. Well, that's what we can do. We can go anywhere because we live here. We can go anywhere else.
But not only the right of free travel, I'm saying 11.
11. 1, 2, 3. Yes, sir.
11.
11.
That's how big they are.
Yeah, 11.
That's how big they are.
Yeah, I can believe that. I'm a firm believer in that.
Right.
1, 2, 3. 4. Yes, sir. 1, 2, yes, sir. Yes, sir. The Soviet Union, the whole half side of the world.
Yeah.
And we're just one little tenth of the globe.
Yeah.
When you talk about fighting, we're a country that we're a firm believer on Christ, and it's called help thy neighbor. Do not kill, do not, steal, cheat, lie from everybody.
So what is your point?
There's two things you don't talk about. One's politics and the other one's religion. The reason you don't talk about them is because they combine in each other. You know what I'm saying?
You know how many time zones there are in the Soviet Union?
You know what I'm saying?
Don't you kid yourself. Thanks, Glenn, for the, just thanks for the good thoughts.
It's the height of the Cold War.
It's the height of the Cold War.
Gunsmoke is number one on TV.
Back in California, the Lockheed Aircraft Corporation had set up a secret factory.
New Rambler wagons are selling for $1,850, including tax and license.
It was known as the Skunk Works.
Eisenhower and Nixon are still at Tucson.
There, in less than a year, it had designed and built a revolutionary new reconnaissance aircraft.
Lockheed Aircraft builds a special spy plane, the U-2.
Even the Russians are marching to a pleasant beat.
The U-2 took off on its first test flight.
The plot? The CIA is overflying the Iron Curtain with secret aerial reconnaissance. Dubbed the Black Lady of Espionage. It can reach altitudes never before touched. At these dizzying heights, it's thought to be invisible to Soviet radar, the ultimate spy in the sky.
Within a year, taken from U-2 flights high above the Soviet Union would reveal that the bomber gap was a myth.
The CIA recruits military pilots to fly these top secret missions. They're supplied with a poison needle and a destruct switch and told not to worry about being shot down because the Russians possessed neither aircraft nor rocketry capable of reaching the U-2's altitude.
More than 30 flights had been made over Soviet territory to hunt for ICBM launch sites.
For almost 4 years, the U-2 had flown safely over sensitive Soviet targets.
But I do say this, our defense is not only strong, it is awesome, and it is respected elsewhere.
Eisenhower could not reveal to his critics the real reason for his confidence, the U-2 evidence. But the U-2 was about to become very public knowledge indeed.
Then on May Day 1960, the skies darkened.
It was only days before a vital summit conference was due to take place in Paris. But the CIA believed that it had hard information about an ICBM launch site in northern Russia. Reluctantly, Eisenhower authorized the flight.
Ike gambled and lost on one last flight. On May Day 1960.
On May 1st, 1960.
Francis Gary Powers takes off from a Pakistani base.
CIA pilot Gary Powers took off in an unmarked U-2 from a secret base in Pakistan.
To fly over the heart of the Soviet Union. Halfway across Russia, the impossible happens. The supposedly invisible plane is shot out of the sky by a Soviet missile. An American spy plane is shot down over the Soviet Union. And the two world powers shake the earth with threats of war.
When Khrushchev announced that a U.S. spy plane had been shot down by Soviet missiles,
initially, the State Department tries to cover up.
The administration claimed that the U-2 was a weather plane which had gone off course.
Claiming the U-2 was a weather plane off course.
It is entirely possible.
Eisenhower goes along with the cover-up story because the State Department guarantees the spy plane is rigged to self-destruct and no one can bail out alive.
Only then did the Russians reveal that the pilot had been captured alive.
But when the Russians reveal that Powers is alive and their prisoner,
on display in Moscow, the wreckage of Pilot Francis Powers' U-2 reconnaissance plane, for Muscovites and foreign newsmen to see.
They have caught the President of the United States in a bald-faced lie. Even the CIA leaves Powers out in the cold.
I saw how devastated Ike was by the U-2 affair. When it was over, it didn't affect the country's view of him. We still liked Ike. But
the U2 mess created a lot of problems. It was a bitter setback.
Something about it.
And you, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to help your Uncle Sam, I hope you do the same.
Sure.
Thank you.
And that's what every good American should do.
Island Records. Island Records. Island Records. Island Records.
They're trying to dark.
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 They were so turned off to that music, including myself. When I first played, I said, is this for real?
Island Records.
They're trying to talk.
Island Records.
Is this for real?
Island Records.
Can't be blasé about it. Might be the music business, but doesn't mean it isn't dangerous. Music business, but doesn't mean it isn't dangerous.
We have to be very strict that no copies under any circumstances can be made. No copies under any circumstances can be made.
This is American Top 40. You have any idea what kind of jeopardy you're putting yourself in?
We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. We'll play ball with it. Okay.
Can't be blocked.
Sue, so listen, we're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that.
Copying is a criminal act.
Oh, come on, oh, please don't sue us.
Copying is a criminal act.
We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that.
Copying is a criminal act.
Oh, my God.
Do you have any idea what kind of jeopardy you put yourself in?
Oh, please don't sue us.
Copying is a criminal act.
We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. Oh, my God.
Copying is a criminal act.
Copying is a criminal act. Copying is a criminal act. It might be the music business, but it doesn't mean it isn't dangerous.
Oh, please don't sue us. We're really sorry about this. Really sorry about that. Hope I'm wrong with you.
Oh, please don't sue us. We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. Hope I'm wrong with you. Oh, please don't sue us. We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. Hope I'm wrong with you. Do you have any idea what kind of jeopardy you put yourself in?
Copying is a criminal act.
This is not all rock and roll, dude.
Oh, please don't sue us.
Rock and roll, dude.
We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. We'll play ball with you. Oh, please don't sue us. We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. We'll play ball with you. Oh, please don't sue us. We're really sorry about this. We're really sorry about that. We'll play ball with you.
Sons and daughters who cannot find understanding in the home, there are 100 evil substitutes abounding everywhere. And oftentimes, which is lost as we love.
pitching logic she won't see. Her motivations are nothing else but you. She couldn't change. Nothing will make her change. It's not a game. I know. Couldn't be a game. It's not a game. I know.
Change that reason. I see forest, stars in the sky at night. I am dreaming, I dream as a child. When I was allowed. When all was simple. When they could penetrate my skin.
Thank you.